Hi, I'm James Leichter from Aptora. I'm glad you're interested in Flat Rate Simple. I built Flat Rate Simple myself to be as simple flat rate as possible. Within about 1 hour or so, you should be able to export your flat rate pricing books and import them into your favorite program. You can also print them if you want a hard copy. In this video, I'm going to give you a quick tour on how to use the system, how to set up the different preferences and settings, and how to get started with flat rate pricing as quickly as possible. I hope you enjoy it. Installation is very simple. Just double click on the zip file to extract the two files. There's only two. I created a folder called Flat Rate Simple inside my normal program files folder. I also put that inside of an Aptora folder. Opening that folder reveals the two files that come with the product. There's a simple README file. You probably don't need to read it. And there's your Excel file. Just double-click on that Excel file to open it. You can also right-click and create a shortcut. And that put a shortcut on my desktop. That way, I double-click on the shortcut. It'll open up this file, which is where most of the program files are kept. When you open the file for the first time, chances are you will land on the instructions worksheet or tab, as I typically call them. You might notice the autosave is turned off. I would leave that turned off if I were you. That way, if you do something to the sheet that you regret, you can always close it and say no to saving it. If you do make changes and you like what you see, click the save button often. Just don't have it autosave. That way, the minute you mess something up, you can close the whole workbook. That's what Excel calls this entire file. And then you can reopen it and continue. This sheet includes some basic instructions on how to use it, but I'm going to show you how to get started quickly. Go to the Setup tab and use the labor rate calculator to figure out what you should be charging per hour. You will notice as I hover over each of these red corners, I'm getting lots of information on what is needed in that field. You'll start out with your labor costs, fringe benefits, etc., and you will get to a number. Enter your desired labor rate here. Now, the calculator is going to populate this field right here. You will need to enter yours in the field below it. So the calculated labor rate is just a suggestion. You don't have to follow that suggestion. In many cases, you probably would put your number there. There are workbook, worksheet, statistics here as FYI. The next thing you want to do is look at your parts and multiplier table. You might want to accept the defaults, or you can change those to meet your needs. The diagnostic travel fee setup is optional. If you want the diagnostic fee and or your travel fee to be built into the task, you can fill out that information here. Your accounting preferences are important, especially if you plan to export this file, and that is probably why you bought this. The purpose of this system really is to be exported. Enter the chart of account number in QuickBooks or Total Office Manager that you want to represent the income account. The invoice item type should probably stay at service. That means it will create a service item type in QuickBooks, Total Office Manager, or other programs. Enter your desired gross profit dollars per hour. You can read about that here. $375 is the default. This shouldn't take long. Once you're finished, it's time to move on to the tasks worksheet or tab. These are your flat rate tasks. If you scroll from top to bottom, you can see that there are quite a few of them. If you'd like, you can filter out by industry or by task category or by both. The industry is the industry that you are in, or at least the industry the book represents. We have the HVAC and refrigeration service book, the plumbing service book, electrical service book. We also have a book we identify as all industries service. Those are tasks that apply to all of the industries. Chances are you don't want to get rid of that. And then finally, we have the HVAC installation book. You can filter simply by checking one of those. And now you're only looking at the HVAC service industry. To go back to how it was, click the clear filter from industry. Now you can do the same thing with task categories. These are all the task categories. And let's say that you were looking for breakers. Type in the word breaker, and you will see breaker panel, breakers and fuses comprehensive. Maybe it's these two that you are looking for. Click OK to filter. And you can see the contents of those categories. The comprehensive belongs to the electrical service book. If you want those in your HVACR service book, then you just have to change to the other industry. Again, to clear, we click clear filter from task category. All of these columns are pretty self-explanatory. If you hover over, you will see, let me scroll to the top. Notice, by the way, let me show you what I noticed. It looked like the tip was incorrect or buggy. Now we'll hover over it. Everything's been explained thoroughly. It's pretty self-explanatory, though. One nice feature is the rounded number. So many people want to round the retail price. This allows you to use both the retail price calculated or a rounded amount. When you export the information, you'll have both. When you import it into your program, then you will have an opportunity to pick which one you want to import. You can inactivate any of these tasks simply by selecting true. That inactivates it. You can also copy down that value. Common. No markup. That will usually be false. There are times where you might not want to mark up the part cost. That does not apply to labor. It applies to the part cost. In this case, the part cost $94.28, or I should say the parts, in case there's more than one thing. It's multiplied by 1.33 for a retail of $125.39. The labor cost is $32.91. It looks to see how many minutes are in the task. There's 45 minutes in this task. So it multiplies 45 by 32.91 to give you a labor retail of $273.75. Your gross profit dollars on labor is $240.81. Your cost of goods sold is $127.19. Your gross profit dollars is $271.96. Again, if you want to know more about any of these values, you'll get an explanation by popping over. The gross profit dollars per hour is an important number, and it tells you if you've met that goal based on how you set up here. $375 is the goal. If we're not making it, it will say no. If we're making it, obviously yes. you can see the date that the task was last revised and the time, and there's room for comments here. The export, the print export settings tab allows you to filter for what industries you want to print your books for. In this case, I'm filtering for the HVAC R, that stands for refrigeration service. All industries is also included. Inactive equal to false. So in other words, I don't want inactive. Tasks can be marked as common. I'm including both true and false, so common and not common. I also have the opportunity to pick from the various categories that are within these selections. You can enter your company's name here, name your book, give it a book title. The flat rate book format is either technician report or manager report. Manager report shows you your costs. The technician's report doesn't. You'll see that in a moment. You can check for duplicated task numbers. You can check for task descriptions that might be too long. This is your export button. You can refresh all of your task information here, and you can sort your task information with this button. We'll talk more about those. Let's go to the printed book tab. Here we have the books ready to be printed. If I scroll down, you can see that we have our industry name, book name, HVAC service, and this is the category, task number description, and the investment, the price. Now, how does that look when it's printed? You can click Control P on your keyboard, or you can hit the print preview button provided. And it shows you your book. Looks pretty nice. You can print that out. You can create a PDF, whatever you do normally on your computer. You will notice that the title that you gave it is at the top, your company name, down at the bottom. We have the page X of Y. You can't control that. This footer is customizable. Prices don't include sales tax. You can modify that if you'd like to, and you're ready to print. The lists are here. These are the various selection lists, your industries, your categories, the departments. This is where you can go to maintain those lists. We've provided a truck stock list template just for your information. It does not make any difference in how you use the software. And we have provided you with tool lists for your installation work and your service and maintenance work. These tool lists don't affect your flat rate book at all. They have just been added for your convenience. Once you get the book looking the way you want it, and that means usually doing a lot of inactivating, getting rid of things you don't need. You might also delete things if you don't need them. Then it's time to export. You can check for duplicates first. Make sure you don't have any duplicate task numbers. Click export. A temporary sheet is created, as you can see here. After that sheet is created, it wants to know where to put that information. And I'll call it FRPO Export 01 and click Save. And that's all there is to creating your export file. If you were to open that export file up in, say, Notepad, then you would be able to see All right, that's all there is to it. Let's go back to tasks. If you want to modify the book, it's been protected. You'll click the unprotect sheet and enter a password. All of the sheets are protected. If you want to give yourself a little bit more room to work, you can get rid of the formula bar. You probably don't need it. You can get rid of the headings. You can go to full screen mode if you like. Those are normal Excel features. I'm just pointing them out. Your task number here is made up of your task number core and your labor time. Again, hover over here for details on how that works. I think that's about it.
Well, I think it's time to wrap up this video. I wanted to keep it as short as possible, but I wanted to do a good job explaining how to use Flat Rate Simple. If you liked the video, please consider giving it a thumbs up, a like, subscribe to the channel. If you have any questions or comments, as always, please leave them below. We would love to hear from you, and I will do my best to answer each and every one of them. Once again, I'm James Leichter with Aptora. Thank you so much for your interest in Flat Rate Simple.